Monsieur Gavet's speciality is making a moricane, an almond meringue dessert to a secret family recipe. First, he pipes the meringue with its secret almond mix using a pochet into different sizes, and then he sprinkles chopped almonds on the top. After an hour in the oven, they go into a warming drawer to dry for 24 hours. Then they're ready to be filled with an almond and buttercream. The sides are dusted with meringue crumbs, and the tops topped with icing sugar. Meanwhile, Bruno is making that all-time French classic, croissant. And there's more to it than you might imagine. After rolling the pastry with the machine, it's cut into triangles, rolled up and shaped into croissants, which is simply the French term for crescents. Then it is brushed with an egg and salt mixture. It then goes into a warming oven for 30 minutes to rise, and then is brushed with more egg and salt mixture and then placed in the oven. Et voila! 20 minutes later, breakfast is served. Creating this wood effect on a thin sheet of sponge is the first stage to making this truly spectacular raspberry gâteau. But it's definitely not one for the Weight Watchers. Crème pâtissière is mixed with kirsch and then whipped cream and then spread over a layer of sponge moistened with syrup. It's followed by a layer of raspberries, yet more cream mixture, and then finally the lid we saw being decorated earlier. Bertrand is a highly experienced chocolatier, and handmade chocolates are another specialty here. After coating in the machine, Bertrand makes different marks according to the centres. For another house specialty, Bertrand cuts the inside of a rolled tube of plastic with chocolate. When cooled, the chocolate tube is cut with a hot knife. And then stuck into the bottom of a glass. Crushed cake is added. Followed by chocolate fondant and fruit. Finally, the tube is filled with a raspberry coulis. To eat, simply break the tube and enjoy. Which these visitors are about to do. Now it's time to get back to our alfresco kitchen in Var.
So we're cooking monkfish à la Française, is it? Or yeah. in the style of
it's a monkfish stew. That's it really.
Because the French would normally do that. Français means peas, lettuce, that kind of stuff.
Yeah. Well, the difference here, we're going to put asparagus in. We've got beans, and we're going to actually, instead of the lettuce, we're using spinach because this is really, really good. Picked up from the market, nice and nice and fresh.
Now monkfish.
Right, monkfish. Well, there's the old monk tail. And obviously, it's about 2/3 of the whole beastie is the flesh, but there's a massive head. And here we've got the skin. This is quite a loose skin. And what you need to do is actually pull the skin away, just tease it off with a knife a little bit, and then you'll find that it should just pull. And there you go. And that
pull
is
off nice and easy.
Your lovely skin. But there's still this membrane. So what we need to do is cut around that. This membrane actually is pretty good for stock.
And what it's a good fish, is monkfish, isn't it? It's quite a meaty fish.
Yeah, it doesn't break down. I think they used to use it as a cheats sort of scampi.
Yeah.
But now again, it's...
Before it got too expensive.
Yeah, absolutely. But you see, it's quite a nice white, clean fish under that membrane. And we just need to sort of get all of that away. And basically that's it.
Okay.
And then what we do is we're just gonna cut it into nice sort of manageable chunks that are gonna cook evenly, but because it's one central bone, and if I show you this one here, you see there's the bone there. There's nothing coming from the sides of it. It's just that one. So that's gonna actually keep the fish moist.
Yeah.
But and also hold it together. So,
yeah.
And then we cut the tail here. And then we've got another one here which we've already prepped up.
Okay.
So we do the same with that. And then into a pan, which we've already got heating up.
Do you want a bit of water in there?
Yeah, a little bit of water. Okay. And then we're gonna cook with some dry vermouth here.
Yeah.
Just for a change. I mean, you could use wine.
So that's when?
A little bit more. Plenty of that there, right. And what that does, it evaporates the alcohol straight away, and you're left with a drier wine taste. So that goes in, and that's really gonna burn off really quickly, but it also reduces down the water, so you're making an instant stock, really, with with the fish. Yeah. And then we're gonna put into that, this is the young garlic, the really soft one. So we're gonna put a whole clove of that in, without chopping it up, we're gonna infuse that, get the flavor out of it, and then we're gonna take it out. So that lid goes on now.
Yeah,
and that's going to have a few minutes to cook. And while we're cooking that down,
prep the asparagus and peas.
Asparagus, peas, and then we've got some beans here to cut as well.
So now you're basically just using the tops of the asparagus.
Yeah, that's right.
But the stalks, I suppose you could use them for soup, stock and stuff like that.
Yeah. I mean, again, it's one of those things that you know this is the prime parts for this dish, but there's a lot more you can do with your other bits and pieces. Yeah. So we're going to shred our spinach. That's going to go in at the end, and then we're going to use here chives instead of onions, because we've got no onions in this dish. Our onionness is going to come from the chives.
Yep.
So therefore,
do you want me to chop those fine?
Yeah, nice and fine those. Right, let's have a look at this monk. So what I'll do now is I'm going to leave the lid off. Now that we've cooked it through slightly, we'll just take the lid away.
It's nice and fine.
Right, the first thing to go in is going to be the asparagus. That goes in. And we'll give that a minute or two.
What are you looking for total cooking time for this? Probably 5-6 minutes.
Six minutes, yeah. I mean, it's because it's super fresh, and what you want is it to be slightly under.
Yeah.
If it goes over, it gets very tough and rubbery. So the idea is that you get that obviously cooking first, and then everything else follows.
Yeah.
And it can all be left, if it's really, really fresh, you can leave it quite crispy, So I'm gonna take the beans now, pop those in. Good scattering of those, that'll do.
Now the spinach, I'm assuming you're gonna put that in right at the last minute.
Right at the last minute, and really all it needs to do is just wilt down. So, right, I'm gonna put the peas in now as well.
Yeah.
So we've got a few of the peas going in, and they're not gonna take long at all because they're so fresh, you want them nice and crispy.
Yeah.
And the garlic here, we're gonna pull that out now, that's done its job.
Lovely.
So that's getting there. And also what I haven't done is season it at all. No seasoning until the very end, because we're evaporating everything, it's obviously reducing. So if we would have seasoned at the beginning, then there's a chance of it being too much pepper or too much salt.
Yeah.
So once we've reduced it and we're happy with the consistency we've got, which is pretty much there, then we're gonna just finish it with the seasoning. So now we're gonna put in the spinach. Give that a good sprinkle in. You just need it to sort of wilt in there. And then we'll get our lemon juice and seasoning in. So now we're looking good. So I'll start the seasoning. Plenty of pepper. Right, good sprinkling of salt. Bear in mind, we've had none at all, so it's right at the very end we're doing this.
Put the chives in now.
And now the chives can go in, and then...
Now, we're in France. We're not using standard double cream like you would get in the UK, so you have to treat this kind of end bit slightly differently, don't you?
Yeah, slightly different, because it does have a tendency to split. So I've turned the heat off now, because everything is just sort of wilted down. We've got a little bit of juice left there, so all we need now is our cream and lemon juice. So let's put the cream in.
If you're using this at home, try and use double cream. It actually will solve this problem. Double cream doesn't split. And the problem is with French cream, is that it does split if you kind of boil it too much.
Let's
so
that.
It needs to go in right at the last minute. A touch of lemon juice.
Yeah. That is, lovely.
Happy with that?
I think that, to me, is...
Right at the last minute.
Pretty good. So let me just, shall I bring it over or dish it out?
There you go, put it on there. You just serve this with just crusty bread?
Just hunks of bread to dip into the sauce.
I have to say, it looks fantastic, considering it's all just cooked in one pot straight away.
Let's get some more of this lovely sauce over there. Maybe another piece of fish. Look at that. What do you think?
Check that out, it looks fantastic.